Gee, this Natural Art History Museum is gorgeous. There's so much to see. I'm such a nerd about these things. What do we have here? Look at this gorgeous painting. My, oh my. See, this represents a garbage truck, if I'm not mistaken. It looks like a destroyed garbage truck. It's very, very artistic. I love the colors on it too. I know I'm not allowed to touch these paintings, but I want to get at least a closer look. Oh my goodness. You can see here all the square shapes, the intricate design. Every cube looks like it was almost carefully placed on the painting. It's crazy how these artworks are made. I was always fascinated by them. Golly gee. What else can I say about this beautiful portrait? I wonder if anyone can help me determine what these actually are, who made them and everything. But this museum's pretty smart to keep people guessing. Guess I have to scratch my chin on this one. Figured I'd bring my camera for this art project and show you guys on Facebook. Hope I'm allowed to record in here. This is gorgeous. I like it. I like what I see so far. It's real pretty and ugly at the same time. That's the best way to describe it. And why would somebody paint a broken garbage truck? That's my question. If it even is that at all, how did that garbage truck get destroyed? I wonder how much this sells for. All I can do is sit here and admire. Anyway, I'm gonna move on to the next painting. This next painting, what can I think about this next painting? Ah, yes. It looks very blue, clearly. Looks like the sea. Maybe something in the Mediterranean. Water's pretty bright there, vibrant. Maybe near Africa, the way the sunlight hits. Looks like a bird's eye view of the water. I love bird's eye view paintings. They fascinate me so much. It kind of looks like Spain. As if they painted the continents out of water. I almost want to dive into the picture. It's so death-grabbing. Like the perception is off balance. I love bird's eye view paintings in general. Fall into it somehow. That's the perfect illusion, so to speak. This next one, I'm not sure how I feel about. Kind of looks depressing. I don't really like it. I would definitely not hang this up in my living room. Nope. I need something cheerful in my home. I wonder how much this painting costs. I see what looks like a Japanese woman. She looks like a ninja, kind of. Why do I feel like this demonstrated the eruption in Japan during the war? I hope not. That's horrible. But it looks like it by the dying trees and the way they have all the life. depressing depiction. Look so precise to what I'm speaking of. I see a red umbrella knocked down on the floor there. I see an ocean wave. Maybe it could have been a tsunami that struck the country. That's the beautiful thing about art is you just don't know what it is. It can be anything and it can be nothing at all. I think I'm thinking way too hard about this one though. I may just have to relax my eyes and just focus a little in the center and then everything will fall into place. Who knows? First grader painted it. Could be a little kid, or could be an adult depicting a child in this art form and pretending to paint it poorly, but they made this centerpiece instead. I would put this over my kitchen table. I don't care how it looks. I'm just curious as to why it was made. What is the purpose this piece was placed here in this very museum? It is the Natural Art History Museum after all, so if you put two and two together, you'll kind of figure it out for yourself, won't you? I like the blues. They're kind of a sickly color, but yeah. The brush strokes look so childish, though, so it makes me think that it was a kid. Anybody knows. That's the crazy question of the day. But I can't help but keep staring. Gosh, I love museums so much. 29. Why is the number 29 specifically there? Is it talking to someone who's 29 years old? I have yet to reach 29. What if someone who's already reached 29 and beyond is looking at this? How would they feel? Is this painting meant to tug at your heartstrings? Is it meant to depict age, that it's timeless and it doesn't exist? What if we all are all 29? What if nobody turned 29 or nobody is 29? Just think we're 29, but 21 is just a number on a painting and nothing more. It is a made-up creation. And why is there rust on the painting? Does it mean that as we age, the less age appears? This painting is almost aggravating me because it's bringing up so many questions. And why the blue? Why is there so much blue? What is the pattern here that is made? Why are the font of the numbers shaped the way they are? It's impressive. Astonishing. I don't know what to say. This one looks like there are a bunch of faces. Alien faces with gas masks on them. Why are there so much orange circles? I heard that this painting was a mistake, but it doesn't appear to be. It looks beautiful just the way it is. How could something this beautiful be a mistake? That is the question. Does the artist believe that it's ugly, but others believe otherwise? Sometimes I wonder how the actual artists must have looked and what they must have been doing at the time of painting their pieces. There's a lot of black for a reason, but what could that reason be? I'm stumped on this one. I can't seem to figure it out. And I'm usually pretty good at detecting people's motives. Maybe if you look at it sideways, sometimes that helps. Or upside down. Now I just look silly. I'm lost. I don't get it personally. It's definitely not my favorite. It's a bit dark, but other than that, it is a masterpiece nevertheless. To me, this looks like the nation's flags all put together. There's the Greek flag, the Moroccan flag, or maybe not. To someone, it could just look like a bunch of stripes and polka dots. Abstract in the sense I see otherwise. You can see what you want to see, but I see what I want to see. That's my perception of it. It's a nice visual. Almost reminds me of those spirals that you stare into and you get hypnotized and sucked right in. I love the colors, very colorful. I love bright, colorful things, things to cheer me up. I feel happy looking at it. It kind of seems like there's a glare of sunlight shining on the walls. It's very, very special. Edgar Allan Poe certainly didn't draw this. This brings so many memories. Memories of a past. There's something there in the cobblestone streets. You don't see cobblestone streets. Definitely European. Kind of rustic, old historic look. Definitely not modern times. Maybe this wasn't, though. I can't say for sure. It was definitely not painted like the 1600s. Don't get me wrong. It's just trying to paint back into the past. That's all I'm seeing. This one's pretty easy to figure out. Or is it? It's just a couple dolphins, but dolphins, I heard, can be genderless because they can prefer one or the other. Huh. Looks like a couple. Why do I feel like this is more representing humans that live their lives together as lovers, but they drew them as dolphins because dolphins are very much like humans in intelligence. And it's so fun how there are stripes through them. Like they didn't just paint the dolphins, they painted them with stripes as well. Do the stripes represent borders in our lives? The things, the thoughts, the very things that we don't tell people about? Are each of these stripes every single lie or secret they hid from one another? Why are they in the water, smiling just like that in that perfect shot, in that perfect pose? Or did somebody simply decide to paint a couple of dolphins one day and just put it up? Why the blue? There's so much blue involved in these paintings. There's a theme here for sure. It's just, I can't put my tongue on it. Blue has a representative you happy. It's just so pretty and vibrant. I don't know what else to say about that one. You think what you want, but I think what I want. It's cute. I would hang it in the hallway if I could buy it. If I could afford it. Another animal. There's definitely a pattern going on. This is very definitely a different artist from the last one, I would say that for sure. Definitely not the same. You'd have to be really is it just one peacock? Why is it just there? And I love how the tail feathers are not painted in the typical way that they are. It's more to the side and just like blended with the painting. Kind of like placed in a box, kind of like the flag painting we saw. This gives a different perspective on life. What is life? Why is that peacock alive? Where is that peacock alive? What is it doing when it's time? How did its feathers get so colorful and vibrant? What does it eat to keep it that healthy? Kind of have to think outside of this box to really bring life into the painting. It almost feels as if it's here with us, just staring at us, smiling, enjoying life together, and not questioning what it is, just being there in that painting, forever locked, trapped in that painting in that perfect moment in time. This kind of emanates Pablo Picasso in a sense, or Van Gogh, or a mix of the two. There's a melting bird or a tree. Looks almost like a flamingo because of the neck shape. There's a doorway, a path to somewhere, but it's uncertain because of the shaky boundaries in between. Like someone wants to decide to go somewhere, but they didn't because they thought it would be a failed dream. So they're melting in their depression as they woe over what could have been. And there's a smoother pathway behind it, beyond the hills, in a checkered tile formation. Why do the clouds look like they are so amber and ashy? Why is this depicting something so very negative, but so very enthusiastic at the same time? As if someone has a motive to do something, but they dare not, out of fear of what's behind that doorway. That's how I feel when I look at this. I'm just stunned. Painting after painting, it made me question life and my reality and what actually is. What do you think? Is it just representing the human body? Why are there so many eyeballs around? Is it a famous person and so many are watching them as they go through their life? There are these gleaming lights aiming for the person as if they think all the attention is on them. They are some superhuman, but they're really not. They are fantasized and portrayed as if they're something. That's why this painting shows the inside of the person, because the inside is the same as all of us. Famous or not, they are humans too. They have blood running through their veins, muscle tissue, a brain, a spine, eyeballs. They are nothing more but what we make of them, just like these paintings in the museum. All of them are everything that we make them to be, or they're nothing at all. They're just a bunch of acrylic on a canvas for all we care. Just sitting there collecting dust. History.